Hello everyone, you're watching Galileosky how-to videos. My name is Andrew and I represent the technical support team. Galileosky trackers allow you to work with geofences of any shapes and use different settings to work with them. For example, create entry limits, set automatic data transmission shutdown, or send notifications of driving entry into certain areas. Today, we will show you how to create polygonal geofences and use them in your projects. You can use any interactive map that supports exporting KML files to create geofences of any shapes, for example, to control driving by certain routes. You can use Google Earth or Google Maps for that, as well as maps from certain monitoring softwares. On this kind of map, you will be able to create two types of geofences: linear for route making and polygon to create borders of different areas. As an example, let's look how geofences are created in the VLAN software. For that, we go to Geofences tab and choose New option. Each new geofence can be given a name. In order to create linear geofence, we choose option Line. New dots are created by double-clicking on the map. After the geofence is drawn, it should be saved. Polygonal geofences are created in the same way. Only the type is chosen as polygon. One tracker can support up to 1,000 geofences, each consisting of up to 2,000 points. Pay attention that the geofences created first will be high in priority if several areas cross each other. After that, you simply export the KML file with all created objects and record it on the microSD card. The file name and the file path should be the same as shown on the screen. After that, the tracker will start checking the geofences automatically.
The KML files can be updated locally as well as remotely using the remote synchronization via WebDAV cloud services. The instruction on this topic can be found in the description to this video. Polygonal geofences can be used in different customer scenarios with the help of easy logic tool. For that, you can use the geofence parameter that shows which of the created geofences is accessed at the moment. Each geofence has its unique number in the same order they were all created, and you can use it to check if the tracker is in a specific geofence and set different reactions for different areas. As we can see, polygonal geofences can be used to create different areas with different shapes, as well as routes for following. It is quite simple and visible. If you have any questions left, you can write them in the comments section. And subscribe to our channel, like this video and ring the bell if you want to be the first to know about Galileosky Tracker's new solutions. Bye everyone!